Alhamdulillah, we are back now, brothers and sisters. Now we do lesson number 7. We did finish lesson number 6. Al-ma'u baridun, Sister Fatima. Inna al-ma'a baridun. Baridun is khabar. And what is underneath, brother? As-sayaratu jamilatun. Wuftada khabar. Inna sayarata jamilatun. Ismu inna khabar inna. Now we are, mashallah, strong in this. We understand it very well. Now you have to follow 2 sentences and make other sentences according to the pattern of these 2 examples. Am min al Hindi anta, am min Pakistan. Sahi? Now we already had our explanation. So when a and am comes and there are 2 things we are asking about, the first thing goes soon after Hamzatul Istifham, and then second thing follows am. Is it clear? You should underline it and try to, you know, make sure that you don't make mistakes, you know. Atabibun anta am muhandisun. Atabibun anta am muhandisun. If you say anta tabibun am muhandisun, that is incorrect. It has to be like this. 2 things, both are separated. One comes after Hamzatul Istifham and the other comes after am. Now, I will start this time with brothers. Anta, then we have Mujtahidun, and then we have Kaslan. Now, brother Muhammad, how will you use A and am in here? Here, brother, you will say, A Mujtahidun Anta Am Kaslanu, diptote. A Mujtahidun Anta Am Kaslanu. Got the idea, brother? That's the way you got to do it. Maybe you should do one more. Okay. Asini Al-Yaban. Now here you got to use min. So use min with these 2. Okay. What will you say? Aminasini. Here. Am min al-Yabani. Khalas? Got the idea? Aminasini here. Am min al-Yabani. Sister Abza, you got it? Brother Hassan. Anta tabi. Anti. It has to be anti. Because it is tabibatun and mumaridatun. So what will you say? Yeah, that is the way it is. Tabibatun anti am mumaridatun with a question mark. Tabibatun anti am mumaridatun with a question mark. That's the way. Very good, brother. That's the way. I like it. Aha. Okay. Brother, Yahudun. MashaAllah. That is perfect, Brother Abdul Samad. That was perfect. May Allah bless you and all of us, inshallah. Amen. Now, Brother Saeed, we have here Masjidun, Madrasatun, and Haza.
Haza, Masjidun, Madrasatun.
No, then it will be wrong, Brother. A masjidun haza.
A masjidun haza.
Madrasatun. Got the idea?
Yeah.
Got to separate them. Cannot bring them together. A masjidun haza. Madrasatun. Inshallah. Okay. We start with Sister Halima now. Go backwards. Sister Halima. Mudarrisi. Very good, brother. As-sayaratul mudiri hadihi am sayaratul mudarrisi. Are you with me, brothers? As-sayaratul mudiri hadihi am sayaratul mudarrisi. Remember, this is the most perfect, eloquent way of saying. If you say the other way, brother, it is wrong. We don't say that in Arabic. Okay? Sister Arifa. MashaAllah. Am mutazawwijun anta am azabun. Azabun means bachelor, brother. Okay, Sister Mamuna. Ammatuka. Akhalatuka hunna am ammatuka. MashaAllah. That is the correct way. Now, Sister Nasreen, it is come Pakistan and Iran. Now, you can use min here. So, what will you say? You will have to say min, add min here. Amin. Pakistan. Huwa. Am. Am min al-Irani, you can say. Am min al-Irani. Min Pakistan huwa am min al Iran? Sister Mehnaz, aap kahenge? Yes. Karibun baituka am baitun. That was really beautiful. Okay. Brother, now we know Ayu, Kullu and Zu. Are you with me? And I told you, most of the time in this case, the translation is done, not the grammar. Most of the time, translation is done, not the grammar. Okay, you just translate. What is the mudiruna zu lihyatin tawilatin? What is the translation? Our mudir has a long beard. That's all the translation. Are you with me? Are you with me, brother and sister? Our mudir, our director, has a long beard. That is the translation. Now, you don't go in the literal translation, because zu means owner or possessor. So you don't say our mudir is the owner and possessor of a long beard. But in Arabic, we'll say like that. Zu means he has. Okay. So we will English say our director has a long beard. Now look at it, brother, carefully. I want you to find out mubtada and khabar. Are you with me? Watch the sentence carefully. Whose turn was there now? Nusrat? See, mudiruna, how many words are there? Two. Mudaf, mudaf ilayhi. So where is our mubtada? Mudiru is our mubtada. Wa huwa mudaf and na mudaf ilayhi. Now where is our khabar? Zu, in this case, zu will be your khabar. Sometimes zu can come as a naat. In this case, Sister Hafsa, Zu is your khabar. Wahua mudaf. And where is mudaf ilayhi? Liyatin. And then what is tabilatin? Naat. See, Fatima? Liyatin tabilatin naat manud. Are you with me, everybody, brothers and sisters? So, liyatin is the mudaf ilayhi. And then tabilatin is naat. Got the idea? Inshallah. Now, Sister Sumayya, Hazad Daftaru, MashaAllah. These are beautiful sentences. This book has lined papers. That's all the English can say. This book has lined papers. Musattarin means the line. Okay, brothers and sisters? Ghairu Musattarin will be plain paper. What is Hazad? Sister Sumayya, when what is the daftaru? MashaAllah. Now where is our khabar? Zu is your khabar. Wahua mudaf. And then mudaf ilayhi. Got the idea? Alhamdulillah. That was beautiful. Now, Sister Fatima, you got a tough question. Ahmadu talibun zu ilmin wa khulukin. So what will you say, Ahmadu? Mubtada. Where is our khabar? Talibun. Talibun is your khabar. Are you with me? Talibun is your khabar. Okay, and then what is Zu doing here? It is your naat here. Are you with me? Now Nu is doing the job of Naat. Wahua mudaf. And then what is ilmin? Mudaf lehi. Wa ataf and khulukin ma'tufun ala ilmin. How will you translate? Ahmed is a student with manners and knowledge. Okay? Ahmed is a, you can also say, a good mannered and knowledgeable student. Are you with me? Ahmed is a well-mannered and knowledgeable student. Are you with me? Ahmadu Talibun. Ahmad is a student. So Talibun is your khabar. And Zu comes soon after Talibun. So Zu is your Naat. Wahua Mudaf. And then Mudaf Ilehi. Are you with me? Inshallah. Who is now? Sister Naima. Hazal Kamisu. Again Hazal Kamisu. Hada Mubtada Al Kamisu. Sister Naima. Badal. Okay. Now we need our khabar. So where is our khabar? Zu. And then mudafilihi kummin. What is kummin? Sleeve. Kummin kathirin. This is, my shirt is zu kummin tawilin. Short shirt will be zu kummin kathirin. Kummin kathirin. Okay, brother and sister. Now look at my shirt. Hazal kamisu zu kummin tawil. And anyone, it's winter, we don't have short shirts. But then if it is a short shirt, we'll say, Hazal kamisu zu kummin kathirin. Kummin is the sleeve. Are you with me, brother and sister? So zu is your, okay. Zu is your khabar. And zaka, zaka means zalika, mubtada. Where is the khabar? Zu. And then kummin is mudafilehi. And tawilin is naat. Are you with me, brothers and sisters? Inshallah. This is a tough cookie. Aiza, the last one is a very interesting. Okay, al-masjidu. Al-masjidul lazi. What is al-lazi? Sister Faiza, what is al-lazi? Ismu mausula, relative pronoun, ismu mausula, okay, fine. Al masjidul lazi fi hayyina, okay. I'm not going to go too much in detail. Inshallah someday we'll get it there. But al lazi, when it comes, it always has a silatul mausul. Remember we did it, silatul mausul. In this case, Sister Faiza, where is Silatul Mausul? Fi hayyina, mashallah. That was good. Put that into bracket, brothers and sisters. Put it into bracket. Allazi fi hayyina. Fi hayyina. Fi hayyina, how many words are there? Three words. Fi, then hayyi, and then na. Okay, fine. Now, the masjid which is in our neighborhood, what about it? Where is the news? Zu, mashallah. Okay, so brother, where is our mubtada? Al-masjid. That is your mubtada. And here I will say Al-Lazi is a naat because it is describing it. What are you describing? And naat. First and foremost, we will always say ism mausula. And then we will say it is also a naat. In this case, it is naat. And then fi hayyina is our silatul mausul. Because it is connected with a allazi. Now, brothers and sisters, I know this is tough.
Did you say this is covering?
No. This is tough. But I do not want you to worry too much about it. If you understand, then I will say alhamdulillah. If you don't understand, then I will say don't worry. Because later on we are going to repeat these things over and over and over again. You know, and you will get it. So Sister Naima, please don't worry. If you get it, alhamdulillah. If you have little difficulty, just ignore it. Just translate. Just translate, okay. So, Because we are doing analysis, so I just want to do it. Al-masjidu, brothers and sisters, it is mubtada. Al-ladhi is ismu mausula, but it is coming as a naat here because it is describing it. Okay? And then fi hayyina, fi harf jar, hayyi ism majrur wa huwa mudaf, na mudaf ilahi. Now this thing is a silatul mausul. This is silatul mausul connected with al-ladhi. Then where is our khabar? Zu. That is your khabar. And then it is mudaf. Manaratin wahidatin. Wahidatin is your naat. Okay. Now, if you remove alladhi fi hayyina, what will you say, Sister Faiza? Remove alladhi and fi hayyina. What will you say? What will you say? The masjid has one minara. That's all. The masjid has one minara. Got the idea? So that is your, dhu is your khabar then. If you say al-masjidu, dhu, manaratin, wahidatin, then dhu is your khabar for masjid. Write down underneath, brother and sister, or on the side. What will you write down on the side? Al-masjidu, dhu, manaratin, wahidatin. Could you please write it down? So you know this is the actual sentence. But then we are describing the masjid in our neighborhood has single minara. Okay, brothers and sisters? Got the idea, Brother Muhammad?
Yes.
Inshallah. Everybody with me, brothers and sisters? Now, here, Dr. Abdul Rahim wants us to practice. Now, this is again something that you will just try to do it. We won't go in detail too much. But the zu is singular. What is the plural of zu? Zavu. It is plural. And zu is a masculine. What is the monist of zu? Zatu. And if zatu is singular, what is the plural of zatu? Zavatu. Okay. Now, as I said, do not put yourself in too much stress to memorize it and you know, just take it lightly. Just do the exercise. Because over the time that we will be studying, you will get very strong, brother and sister. Look at this example. Hada talibu, what is hada? Mubtada. What is talibu? Badal. Where is the khabar? Zu khulukin. This student is well-mannered. This student is well-mannered. Fine. Now change that into plural. Haulai tullabu. What is haulai? Mubtada. What is attullabu? Badal. And then what is zabu? Our khabar. Wahua mudaf. And khulukin is mudafili. Very good, brother. Hazihi talibatu. What is hazihi? Mubtada. What is at-talibatu? Badal. And then what is zatu? Khabar. Wahua mudaf. And then khulukin is mudafilihi. This female student is well-mannered. Fine. Haulai talibatu. Haulai talibatu. Haulai talibatu. Zawatu khulukin. So, ha-ulai, our mubtada. What is at-talibatu? Badal. And what is zawatu? Is your khabar. Wa huwa mudaf. And then mudaf ilay. Brother Muhammad?
Yes.
This is very simple if we try to analyze it. Okay? Otherwise, zu, zavu, zatu, zawatu. If you remember, alhamdulillah. If you don't remember, don't worry. It will come in the lessons, inshallah. Now we got to do our own. We got to do our own, brothers and sisters. هَذَا الرَّجُلُ ذُو مَالٍ كَثِيرٍ. Let us analyze this. هَذَا مُبْتَدَى الرَّجُلُ بَدَل. Where is our khabar? ذُو. And what is مَالٍ? مُدَافِلِهِ. What is كَثِيرٍ? نَات. مَالٍ كَثِيرٍ. Can I point out my finger to Brother Muhammad and say, هَذَا الرَّزُلُ ذُو مَالٍ كَثِيرٍ. I can point out to Brother Abdul Samad and say, هَذَا الرَّجُلُ ذُو مَالٍ كَثِيرٍ. هُوَ تَاجِرٌ. Now how will you make it? Okay, Brother Rajulu, what is the bonus of Rajulun? Al-Mara'atu. 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 Okay, sorry. First we have to do plural. Sister Suhaina, it is your turn now, sister. Make hadha rajulu into plural. Yes. Say it again, sister, one more time, loudly. See, ha'ulai rijalu, not rijalun. Rijalu. Okay, badal. Okay, ha'ulai rijalu. Zavu. Malin. Kasirin. You write it down, brother, inshallah. Now, then how will you say your sister Hafsa? Make it hadha rajulu into muannas? No, muannas now. Hadhihi al-mar'atu. What will you say? Hadhihi al-mar'atu zatu malin kathirin. Very good, mashallah. Now, brother, you have to say now,
Haulai.
No, Nisaun. Mar'atu, plural is Nisaun. Haulai Nisa'u, Zawatu, Malin, Kasir. Das. Write it down at home, do this exercise, you'll become strong, inshallah. Are you with me? And the concept is very clear with you, inshallah. Okay, brother. This is again Halwa Puri. You will have no difficulty in doing it. We really want to finish the lesson so that we can start a new lesson tomorrow, inshallah. I have some handouts to give you. Please do collect your handouts, because tomorrow, if possible, I'll explain you extra things about Inna. The things that we do in Book 3. But I want to do it now with you, so that you see with Inna something else comes in the Quran, and I want you to enjoy it and feel it in your heart, you know. So what is this extra thing? I'm going to leave the handout with you. You will read it, inshallah, and tomorrow I will explain you. It's so beautiful, brother. When you understand this, then brother, there's nothing sweeter than Quran. There is nothing more eloquent than Quran. It is so beautiful. Then, you know, you will say, I just want somebody to recite Quran in Arabic, and I want to listen to it and understand it directly, inshallah. We said, Inna has many sisters, and La'alla is one of the sisters. So whatever Inna does, whatever Badi Behan does, Choti Behan also does the same thing. Okay, brother? Huwa bi khairin. Where were we? Now, brother Hassan. Huwa bi khairin. La allahu bi khairin. Khalas. So when you say la allahu min akhwatu in. La allah min akhwatu inna. At this juncture, we say it is the sister of inna. La allah min akhwatu inna. Are you with me? Fine. And then what is who? Brother Hassan? What is who now? Ismu la'alla. It's easy. But then also, Brother Hassan, you will say Ismu la'alla mansubun. Are you with me? And what will you say? Bi khairin? Jar majrur. Shubu jumla khabar. Khabar of what? Khabar la'alla. Okay, do one more, brother. You got to do one more. Bi khairin. It's easy. So what is la'allahum? What is la'alla? La'alla is min akhwatu inna. What is it? Min akhwatu inna. It is sister of inna. Say? لعل من أخواته إن. Okay, brother? Now tell me what is whom? مجرور. شبه جملة. خبر. لعل. Are you with me? Because now لعل has come. So you will say اسم لعل and خبر لعل. Are you with me? When إن came, we said اسم إن and خبر إن. Now لعل has come, we'll say اسم لعل and خبر لعل. If لكن comes, then we will say اسم لكن and خبر لكن. If أن comes, أن, then we will say اسم أن and خبر أن. When if say كأن, so then you will say اسم كأن and خبر كأن. If I say ليت, يا ليتني كنت تراب, you know, so that is also sister of إن. So if you say ليت, then there will be اسم ليت and خبر ليت. Are you with me, brother? It's very simple. Huh? Inshallah, if you will practice, think about this. اسم لعل and خبر لعل. Brother of the Samad, هي بخير. لعلها. Okay. Brother, I think let us brush up our 14 pronouns with لعلها. Ready? With a huwa. لعله, لعلهما, لعلهم, لعلها, لعلهما, لعلهن, لعلك, لعلكما, لعلكم, لعلك, لعلكما, لعلكن, لعلي. What is it? لعلي. And then لعلنا, لعلنا. Okay, fine. Now, لعل. Okay, لعل. Okay, لعل. And then the ism is mansub. لعله, لعلهما, لعلهم. لعلها, لعلهما, لعلهن. لعلك, لعلكما, لعلكم. لعلك, لعلكما, لعلكن. لعلي, لعلنا, لعلنا. One more time I'll say, brother, sister. لعله, لعلهما, لعلهم. لعلها, لعلهما, لعلهن. لعلك, لعلكما, لعلكم. لعلك, لعلكما, لعلكن. لعلي, لعلنا. الحمد لله. جزاكم الله خير. So, okay, you do one more, brother of the summit. لعلهن بخير. So, brother, what is لعل? من أخواتو إن. It is from the sisters of إن. And هن became اسم لعل. اسم لعل منصوب. What will you say? اسم لعل منصوب. Very good. And then what is the بخيرين؟ جار مجرور شبه جملة خبر. لعل. خبر لعل. ما شاء الله. Brother Saeed, you do the next one. أنت بخير.
لعل.
أنت will become لعلك.
لعلك
بخير. بخير. Are you with me? لعلك بخير means I hope you are well. Okay. So لعل is من أخوات إن. And كا is اسم لعل منصوب. Is everybody following me? Inshallah. I'm repeating the same things, brothers and sisters. And there is the khabar of la'alla bi khairin. Jar majrur shubu jumla khabar. Got the idea, brother? Saeed, inshallah. Sister Arifa? Okay. Describe it, sister. La'alla min akhwatu inna. Ki ismu la'alla mansoob. Sahi? Huh? And then bi khairin? Jar majrur shubu jumla khabar la'alla. Okay, Sister Nasreen. Ana najihun. La'alli najihun. La'alli najihun. Well, how will you translate? You have given your examination. Now you are saying, la'alli najihun. I hope I will pass, or I will, I'm the one who will pass. I hope I pass. I hope I pass. I am the one who has najihun, the one who is successful in the exam. Okay? So if you say la'alli, la'alla min akhwatu inna, where is the ismu la'alla? Ya mutakallim. Are you with me? How will you write down, brothers and sisters? La'alli. How many words? Two. Okay? La'alla min akhwatu inna. Ya mutakallim ismu la'alla mansubun. And where is the khabar? Najihun. Are you with me? Yes, sister Mainaz. La'allana najihun. We hope we are successful. Are you with me? So, la'alla min akhwatu inna and na. Ismu la'alla mansub and najihun is your khabar. Najihuna is your khabar. Are you with me? La'alla min akhwatu inna na ismu la'alla najihuna khabar la'alla. That's the way, inshallah. Now, sister Nusrat. Al-Mudira. Lurfatiya. What is the translation? I hope the Mudiri is in his room. So, La'alla al-Mudira. La'alla al-Mudira. Like Inna al-Mudira, same way La'alla al-Mudira. Fil gurfati, so fil gurfati is your jar majur shibu jumla khabar. Okay? And la'alla mudira, if min laqatu inna al-mudira, ismu la'alla mansub. Very good. Now, this is a very nice sentence, Sumayya. You will always say this when you write exam. What will you say? La'alla ikhtibara. Ikhtibara. Remember, it's easy. Don't forget. Ismu la'alla or mansub. La'alla al-ikhtibara sahlun. Can you translate? See, la'alla can either show hope or fear. These are all hope, showing all hope. La'alla al-ikhtibara sahlun. MashaAllah, that's all you hoped. I hope the examination is easy. So where is the ismu la'alla? Al-akhtibara. Where is khabar? Sahlun. MashaAllah, that was beautiful. Now, in the next lesson, brothers and sisters, we are coming across a verb. What are we coming across? I will use 3-4 minutes to tell you a little bit. We haven't done our verbs. Here is a verb, brother. What is the verb? Laysa. This is a very nice verb, brother. This is not regular verb. This is a weak verb. Laysa. What is in the middle? There's a ya. And also ya has a sukoon. Now we have to remember that in Arabic, two sukoons cannot come together. Cannot come. Because you cannot pronounce. And if the two sukoons come, then if one of the two sukoon is a weak letter, then we drop it. So ya is dropped then. If the two sukoons come, ya is dropped. Ready? Start conjugating. Laysa. Laysa. Laysu. Laysat. Laysata, and then we stop because hunna special condition. What are the conditions for hunna, brother? Watch this. Laysa, and then we put hunna. Are you with me? Now, first radical, second radical, third radical. Fa kalima, ain kalima, lam kalima. When hunna comes, condition is the lam kalima should get a sukoon. If I put a sukoon here, then there is a sukoon here. Oh, I have a problem. I cannot pronounce. So then, I drop it, ya. Why I drop the ya? Because it is a weak letter. Ya and vau are weak letters when they come in the verb. Okay? So, brothers and sisters, what will be now? Lasna. If I know lasna, brother, then where I am now? If I know lasna, where I am now? I'm 407. When I come to lasna, where I am now? I'm 407. So I know what to do next. Speed up. What will I say? Lasta, lastuma, lastum, lasti, lastuma, lastunna, lastu, lasna. So simple, brother. Can you say fast like me? Try it. Lasna, lasta, lastuma, lastum, lasti, lastuma, lastunna, lastu, lasna. Ta tumatum, ti tumatunna, tuna. That's all. So now you do the whole thing. Laisa, laisa, laisu, laisat, laisata, lasna. Lasta, lastuma, lastum, lasti, lastuma, lastunna, lasna. Lastu, lasna. Brother and sister, if we do not understand this concept, then you will say, what kind of a, where are we going? When you say lasna, where did the ya go? But why did ya disappear? Because when you came to hunna, the condition was the third radical should get a sukoon. When we gave the third radical sukoon, we ended up with having two sukoons. And now that is not possible in Arabic. So one of the sukoon has to be given a pink slip. We all understand in Canada pink slips. Okay, so we gave a pink slip to ya and you said, bhai, you take a vacation now. And then what is left now? Lasna. What is left now, brother? Lasna. Brother and sister, try to conjugate this on a piece of paper. We got lots of conjugation paper. Mashallah, mashallah. One more time, brother and sister. Laisa, laisa, laisu, laisat, laisata, lasna. Lasta, lastuma, lastum, lasti, lastuma, lastunna, lastu, lasna. Sister Afza, can you say loudly? Starting with laisa, start. Laisa, laisa, laisu, laisat, laisata, lasna. Mashallah, lasta, lastuma, lastum, lasti, lastuma, lastunna, lastu, lasna. But that is easy. Trust me, this is pure halwa puri. Okay? Well, meaning and everything we'll do tomorrow. We'll do tomorrow. But I just thought at least you know that the conjugation is done like this. It will save time tomorrow. We'll do the meaning tomorrow. And what does Laisa does, we'll do tomorrow. Okay? Rabbana atina fi dunya hasanatan wa fil akhirati hasanatan wa qina azab an-nar. Rabbana hablana min azwajina wa zuriyatina qurrata ayunin waj'alna lil muttaqina imama. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka anta samiul alim wa tub alayna.